Right. Yeah. And he makes plays. Obviously, he makes plays with his feet, and he can throw the ball. It's a challenge. When you're playing a number one team in the nation, it should give you extra incentive. I've been involved in these. I was thinking about the other day. I've been involved with four. We faced number one Notre Dame when I was playing, and we lost by 1 point. Then the same season, we placed number one Michigan, and we beat them. We weren't a great team. And then when I was coaching, we played number one Ohio State. And when I was at Michigan State, we beat them. And when I was at UCLA, we played when the Trojans were on those six championships run, we played them and beat them. So I just stressed to the guys, hey, it's possible. You just got to work and you got to go out and just play as hard as you can. It is a possibility.
What makes that happen? You know, what is that X factor to be the underdog and pull those upsets?
It's the energy. It's the guys playing hard. It's the energy. You got to catch a few breaks. You got to get turnovers. You got to do all that good stuff on defense. But the main thing is you just got to play hard and have some things go your way.
What do you see from Kylan Whitner and any young player on the defense?
He's very smart. He's picked up the system extremely well in terms of, I mean, he still makes mistakes, but for a guy that we were expecting to play to come in and have to give him a lot of reps, he's done an excellent job in terms of knowing what's going on.
What are the mistakes and what is he kind of doing to improve on those kind of things?
No, it's just basic mistakes that people make. He's had some, you know, we played him against earlier in the season, and it was the first time he was playing. He was supposed to be in middle field, and he jumped something. They hit one behind. You know, those are going to happen when you play those young guys, but he's improved on that. As I always say, they're going to make the mistakes. Do they learn from it? Now he's never where he's supposed to be in the middle field. He's in the middle field. So made a mistake. Now address it and improve from it.
High percentage passing game, Chuck, for Clemson. What do you see out of how they try to move the football?
Yeah, they're going to be quick passing game, and then he's going to take some shots because they got some athletes outside, but they're going to run the ball. They run the ball extremely well. They got a good offensive line. They got a good running back, and the quarterback can run too. So they're going to try to run the ball, and then they're going to try the quick passing game. And then when you start playing a lot of guys in the box, they're going to try to chuck it up top.
Yeah, Gallman's obviously been very effective this year, but again, you've probably faced the two top running backs, or could have, and Cook would have been another of the top running backs in the country. Is there anything that differentiates him from somebody else?
No, when you get down to the top teams in the conference, Florida State and Clemson, they're going to have backs. They're going to have three or four or five backs. Mm-hmm. They've done a good job, both programs, in terms of developing their stuff, and they get the best athletes, obviously, and they're going to have one, two, three. They're going to just keep powering in. You just got to be able to play fundamentally sound football. You got to stay in your gaps. If it's a run game, you got to pass fit. If it's a pass, you got to see the right pass fit. It's basic football. It doesn't change from week to week. They just got a little bit more athletes than you're normally going to see.